Consider yourself lucky if our paths never cross. Except, luck isn't real.
The thing that interested me about the graphic novel was this idea of intercepting thought and how intercepted thought is proffered in cinema. You sat down, the movie begins, and you hear something that is deeply personal.
I serve no god, I fly no flag.
And I think that most people feel that what they're hearing is the unadulterated truth. What is voiceover? What does it mean? And we started talking about the idea of this mantra. This is my framework. This is how I understand what it is that I do for a living. And I'm not a serial killer. I'm somebody who solves a problem for somebody else.
Stick to your plan. Anticipate. Don't improvise. Fight only the battle you're paid to fight. Forbid empathy.
And what if that begins to crumble and you start to lose a brick here and a brick there?
Stick to the plan. Stick to the plan. Stick to your plan.
Let's rattle the cage of what a voiceover is meant to exist for. And what if this is self-delusion? There are tropes in assassin movies that I question. And the idea of the men in black basement with all the stainless steel and rack after rack after rack of different rocket launchers.
There are more than 50,000 storage facilities in the US. I like to imagine the episode of Storage Wars, where they cut the lock on one of mine and get a look inside.
And he wants to keep a low profile, so he's not driving Aston Martin DB12. With the wardrobe. This guy has to be able to put an entire ensemble together walking through an airport. So Skechers, yeah, because there's a Skechers store in an airport.
My camo is based on a German tourist I saw in London a while back. No one really wants to interact with a German tourist. Parisians avoid them like the rest of the world avoids street mimes.
In revenge movies, there's something to the construction of a character getting back at the people who've done him wrong.
Nothing like this will ever be allowed to happen again.
And generally speaking, you give him free rein to do whatever he feels is appropriate in terms of his response. And I like the idea of you're invested in this guy who's wearing a costume and he has to pretend to be a delivery person and he has to get through this security door and he has to time it all out. Normally, in these kinds of movies, the audience goes, great, he's gonna get his revenge. And what we wanted to play with was, oh, great, he got in the room with a nail gun. I'm not sure I wanna see what comes next.